I'm Randy Longenecker, Assistant Dean for Rural and Underserved Programs at Ohio University's Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine. And for the past year and a half, I have been given the task of developing tracks for students interested in pursuing rural and urban underserved practice. I'm receiving the Outstanding Educator Award for 2014 from the National Rural Health Association.
Dr. Longenecker teaches you not what to think, but how to think. For me, that's very important, the way he approaches issues, his passion for rural health, and the passion shows when he talks to his students, and he encourages them to pursue something that they otherwise couldn't think they could.
He has many years of experience as a rural doctor. And so he brings all of that experience to us as medical students in first and second year, and we're craving clinical experience. And so he can tell us stories and encourage us to reflect on our goals or what we're thinking or some habits and different things. And he does it in an extremely unassuming way. He's a great teacher.
He's been consistent. I mean, just going even back to his track record, he's been worked with rural health for a long time, and then he came to OU-HCOM. In 2012, he started the Rural Urban Scores Pathway, the RUS program, and that's been impactful. It's been actively engaging. It's getting people actively involved in primary care and family medicine and rural medicine.
He's not afraid to say that what he brings is valuable. He's very straightforward and very honest with himself and others, and I've always felt respected by him as an equal, as a peer, which encourages me to act more that way, act as if, you know, because I want to be worthy of that respect that he gives.
Well, I've received some awards for my teaching in the past, but this is the first that the nomination spontaneously came from students, and that's special. I really dislike the idea of me as the teacher, the student as the passive recipient, and framing education as knowledge transfer. I guess I'd like to say I'm very grateful for the teachers I have had who modeled this kind of teaching for me, beginning with my parents, who were the first teachers. I also want to thank my patients, who were incredible teachers to me, and the students,